Hey everybody, and welcome to a new series on the channel. This is Don't Starve Together. I'm joined by Sir Mobius.
What's up, guys?
We're in a Don't Starve world, and we should probably, like, actually start doing stuff since we wasted a fourth of the day already. So, Mob, I know you have not played a lot of Don't Starve. You just said good day to me. That's amazing.
I don't know.
Cool. We're just gonna hop right in. Mob, you have never played Don't Starve, right?
Never. This is my first minute of gameplay.
Well, this is gonna be
a
riveting time. Okay, that's cool then. I'm gonna give you, like, a couple of tips and tricks. One, I have no freaking clue what this giant thing is. Juicy berry bush? This is brand new to me. Dude, I have no idea what that is.
Well,
so
we can eat it, so I think that's good.
That is a huge positive. That is absolutely for sure. Don't pick flowers is my big tip right off the bat.
Why?
I'm guessing you've already picked some flowers.
I mean, yeah, because you can make a flower crown for insanity.
Okay, I suppose making a flower crown early does have benefits. But otherwise, you want to leave flowers on the ground because picking them increases your sanity. And also they spoil, and eating them regenerates health. So you kind of want to save them for when you really, really need them.
That makes sense.
Yeah, but the flower crown is good. I mean, that's a good start. The main thing we need to do today is actually find, like, a base. And there are some, like, sleeping armadillos out here that look like they're ready to kill us. So I'm going to recommend not going right.
Sleeping armadillos. What?
Dude, go look up there.
Oh.
You tell me what those things are. Those look like sleeping armadillos to me.
Aren't armadillos it's
like a gecko.
The things with the shells that curl up in a ball?
Yeah, these are geckos.
I
moused over them. Oh, and they're like stuff. Totally afraid of us. Yeah, they're totally afraid of us. So I will happily take the grass.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're totally never going to attack us, so that's absolutely fine. This is a good area to get stone. But this might not be the best area to set up a base. Although we're going to have to, like, set up shop here soon.
Yeah, we're gonna
because it's getting
build a fire.
Dark. Yeah. We should look. There's so many geckos up here, dude. They could be a really good source of, like, food early on if we fight them. But that might not be the best idea on the planet. We want to find a place, a savanna that has the stupid what in the world. Oh god, it's laser eye man. North is scary, okay? Stay away from laser eye man.
Alright.
That was my name for this guy in like a playthrough 3-4 years ago. So I've revived it. Flint is good. Pick up okay, yeah, you got it. Cool. Well, I say we explore until we literally have to set up a fire, and actually, I can't even set up a fire,
because
we don't have any wood. We don't have any wood. We don't have any wood. Mob, we need to run. In your tools, on the top left, make an axe.
I just did.
Okay, cool. And then we need to go, because we need wood, like, right now. So this is going to end absolutely deleterious for us. If deleteriously? Horribly? That's a better word, huh? if we just... Okay. We're back in the land of the geckos. You run faster on roads, so it's usually better to run on the road. There's like a ton of wood just chilling here. Okay. There's also a shovel just chilling in the ground, so that's also cool. Okay, get some wood. We'll survive this night totally fine. I'm a little bit concerned, and this is gonna sound stupid as all hell when I say it.
I don't have enough to make a fire.
Just a normal campfire?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I do. So, we'll be A-okay. The number one thing I'm concerned about to start off here, as cheesy as it's gonna sound, I'm a little bit concerned about us starving. Because, like, what? Oh, there's a savannah right down here. This is good. Despite the name of the game being Don't Starve, like, In single player, it's still really freaking hard to survive in terms of food, especially when you get to winter. So we need to make sure that we are, like, top tier prepared. We can carry suspicious marble. Dude, yeah. This thing is heavy as hell. I'm gonna put this down. Yeah, okay, where are you at?
I'm right here.
You're right here? Oh, dude, this is actually a good place for a base as well. So I'm going to... Well, I mean, we only need a temporary fire tonight. But you want to stay in the savannas for bases, at least how I've determined it. Because these little holes, the rabbit holes, you can put traps down. And then that becomes good meat, like, forever. So... That's a good thing. You always want to cook your food before you eat it. So just, you know, take random food in your inventory, and then apparently I just gave you a carrot, so it's happy birthday.
How do I cook it?
Pick up the food, and then left-click it on the fire, and that will cook it, and then you can right-click it to eat it. And obviously you have your three stats, your hunger, your...
Alright.
You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, I was just making sure.
It, like, clicked to cook it, but I ate it. It was weird.
Oh, yeah. That also happens, like, 24-7. Because, I don't know. It's very annoying. We should find a place to call, like, our absolute home. Because we probably should be setting up a permanent base.
All right, well, I just set a trap down.
Okay. I think that we should maybe stay in this region.
I kind of like this region. It's the stones and stuff.
Yeah. You know what? Well, this is a little strange. We can go right by this path over on the left over here. And then that's near three rabbit holes. There's already some blades of grass here.
There's a bunch of rabbit holes here.
Yeah. And it's right by, I like being by a road, first of all, but I like being by water, just because there comes a time, like, 8-10 days in, where you start to have, like, attacks at night, and to have, like, an area walled off is usually a pretty good thing. So, I'm kind of feeling, like, right here for a home, because we got two rabbit holes right here. And then we got the road right here. You know what? I'm going to make an executive decision. I don't have enough stone, so I'm not going to make the executive decision yet.
How many do you need? Oh, never mind. I'll go get
some. I need five more, but yeah, we should go mine anyway because we need gold to make the science machine. And that guy has gold in it, so that's good. I'm really tempted to beat up one of these geckos, but I know that's a bad idea. Because that thing will probably, it'll probably, like, turn into some mutant spider and just, like, one-shot me.
Yeah, that would never be a good thing.
Yeah, not really. You'll learn real quickly that basically everything in Don't Starve wants to kill you.
Oh, yeah.
Except for the birds, but even then, you know, there's a good chance. Is there some kind of weapon that I can... You know what? Screw it. I'm going to attack this gecko. And we're going to see what happens. It's running like hell away from me. I don't think these guys will actually attack me. So, if we can corner them, I think that this could be really good.
Right.
They fall asleep. So, like... Okay, I'm just patiently... This is the battle of me versus this gecko right now. you got him cornered.
How do you attack?
Here we go, boys. You just left click. There we go. Okay. So cool. We got one piece of leafy meat, which granted sounds disgusting, but still food, so I'll take it. Yo, we can totally double team.
Oh.
Never mind. He ran into the other biome here. All right, let's get... if you want to fight that guy, sure. I'm going to go set up a campfire, which is basically just a permanent home for us. Bing, bang, and boom. And I think right here is good enough. And we can make more of these. If we want to change our base sometime, we can do so. But I don't necessarily think that's necessary in the mean big middle picture of our playthrough right now. There's a science machine. Happy birthday.
Oh, okay.
So this thing...
I was just going to make one.
Oh, okay. Well, Perfect. Works for me. I'm gonna prototype rope immediately. And I'm going to attempt to make myself a spear, and I would highly recommend you do the same. That's if I can remember where it is. It's in here. Okay, so a spear, beautiful. I now have
Where?
one. It should be in the attack or fight section.
Fight. Okay.
In
I
survival,
need
I got another
rope.
trap. Yeah, rap. You can get some rap by going to soundcloud.com, checking out my mixtape. You can go to the
Okay.
refine tab to make rope. And that should be good. Make sure you're keeping track of your hunger. If you cook things that become stale, they no longer become stale, which is a very useful tip. So, like, my berries were starting to go stale, so I'm just cooking all of them. This is also a crap load of berries. And honestly, what we should be, like, our game plan early on here. Oh, dude, these do so much, hunger.
What?
Holy hell.
What do?
The juicy berries,
Really?
they're
Oh, they do.
incredible. Yeah.
We should
Okay,
shovel
I
them up
think.
and put them near our
Yes.
base. I have a
Yes.
shovel ready.
So do I. So that is a great, fantastic idea. And there's actually one right up here. We have a lot of time still in the night. There's no reason for us
Oh,
to.
there's a spider.
There is a spider. I may go kill it. Okay.
Oh, he's
Cool. I'm just
coming
gonna
after me.
plant this bad guy right here.
I got two more over here.
Okay, cool. Now those aren't gonna grow yet.
We need
Cause we
fertilizer.
need. Yeah, we need to poop on them. So.
We need to poop on them.
I mean, that's the most delicate way of saying it, I suppose.
Where did you put
We gotta
yours?
go.
Oh, okay, I see.
Yeah. And don't mind me. I'm doing stupid things. So. Ow. Oh, okay, beautiful. Silk is good. You need that much later. Monster meat is not as good. If you eat it on its own, it will harm you, but you can put it into recipes, I believe, once we get a crock pot, and then that will be fine. However, crock pot, raindrop, drop top requires charcoal, so we need to light some trees on fire, basically. And I'm just gonna go do this right now.
All right.
So light that up. Light that up. And that should light me on fire, so that's good. Light that. And this is usually not a smart thing to do in giant forests for quite obvious reasons. But we need the charcoal, so I'm rolling with it. And that stuff will be. I hope that fire does not spread to our berry bushes. I'm gonna be one really sad human being if that does. Okay, I don't think it will. I have some ash. I don't think we can use ash for literally anything. So that's fine. You should be getting
Yep,
back
I'm coming.
shortly.
I was just grabbing a berry bush quick.
Okay, I'm going to throw some logs on yield fire. And we should be good to go here. So, if we chop this, we'll get charcoal out of it. I just realized I'm in pure darkness. Cool. Awesome. Here's some charcoal. I'm just gonna chuck this on the ground for now. We should, in the morning, make it a priority to chop down some trees. Because also, dude, I have the Weekend at Bernie's teddy bear. Hell yeah, boys. This is a tribute to the greatest Ultimate Chicken Horse player I've ever played with, Bernie, the man from Spain. You
Really?
probably don't understand the reference. He was
No.
not the best player I've ever played with.
All
He was
right.
absolutely horrible. I'll tell you a little bit more off camera, but I feel like it's not a story that is worth repeating in a Don't Starve video. People on my channel likely have a fond recollection of Bernie. It was a really interesting time. Basically, like, we had to play in a tournament together, and he was from Spain, and he said some things that were not necessarily appropriate for repeating on this video. So, okay, we got six charcoal. I'm gonna attempt to get us the do we have six charcoal? No, we got five charcoal. I'm gonna attempt to get us the crock pot going because it's like 10 times better for making food.
Yeah.
We should also, in terms of survival related stuff, we should be trying to make a... Oh god, where the hell is it? Maybe it's in science. We should be... Well, we should try to make an alchemy engine as soon as possible as well. But there's basically a refrigerator somewhere. That's also something that we should be looking to do.
I know we'll need as soon as possible. Bones eventually.
Yes. Those... We got a lot of time because I'm pretty sure it's spring right now. So we still have all of summer, fall, and winter. Or all of summer and fall before winter. Winter's nasty. I mean, that will likely be where our downfall is in winter. I'm just accepting it at this point. But we'll do our best to make it there. Yo, don't eat spoiled stuff, actually. My sanity just dropped by, like, 60. Oh, cool. That's a good thing. Because we're going to start collecting a lot of crap. Hey,
dude, two of our traps, sir.
Awesome. You're going to be able to get a live bunny from it, murder it in your inventory, which just, it's a little disturbing, but, you know, make it happen. And then we'll be able to cook those guys tonight.
Alright.
I'm doing a metric butt ton of mining right now, and just getting a ton of stone, flint, etc. I'm also seeing things because I'm going insane, so that's good. Alright, when it starts raining, that's when we're going to have a bad time, because everything starts to flood, and then, like, everything in your inventory is soaked, and you can't use anything, and, like, the stuff breaks easier. It's horrible.
Really? I've never seen rain.
Yeah, it's part of the expansion that is not in... Well, it's in the original Don't Starve if you pay for it, but it's in Don't Starve Together just by default, so...
We're gonna find fertilizer too.
Yeah, we need poop. It's a big must. Is we need to go find poop. And honestly, we might want to explore through the night right now, and maybe just set up a temporary base somewhere. Yo, I got frogs attacking me. What the frick? Get back, frog! We're having frog legs for dinner, Mob. Screw these.
Animal track.
Okay, yeah, that's the elephant.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Yes, that's the elephant. We probably do not want to fight him yet. What I am going to fight are these frogs to an extent, even though they're probably going to wreck me. I'm doing, like, the most evasive maneuvers right now.
I didn't mean to do that.
People on my screen are going, Tyler, what in the hell right now? I'm also, like, maybe going to die, but that's beside the point. Ow. Yeah, this is going, like, super poor. Jesus. They're brutal, dude. I'm, like, almost dead. Okay. Well, one more hit on this guy. Screw that times 400. I'm literally on 20 health. Okay. I'm going to eat... Well, there's not much to eat.
Do you have wood?
I don't have any wood.
Oh.
Yeah, just like, we got time. Chop down a tree. And then what you actually want to do, don't put just straight up tiny logs onto the fire. Make a board in the refining menu and then put that on the fire. And it's like 10 times better than putting wood on.
Alright.
So. And then we'll want to cook up some food. I maybe might be able to make the crock pot here shortly, so... I will try that. I'm just also trying to eat some of these damn flowers since I apparently don't know how to handle frogs in this damn game. And I'm coming back with another berry bush too, so. Once those get fertilized, we're sitting like super pretty on food because these are so good.
There's a mole here.
There is a mole here. I don't think he can do anything to us, so maybe just leave him be, but... Okay. Beautiful. So, combine those.
I killed
Combine
him, I think.
those. Cool. That works for me. I'm going to put a log on the fire
Right, I can't pick this.
now. Beautiful. And then frog lay. I mean, we can make some meals here. I'm gonna chuck some stuff in this chest. We don't need this goal. Yeah, okay, you already have stuff in here. Cool. Pine cones. We can just put these up here, I suppose. All this charcoal I will pick up. Beautiful. And let me see if I can make a crock pot now. So, food. Da-da-da. I need some more sticks and then these cut stones. Do you have sticks on you
I
by
have
any chance?
two.
Okay. I need more than two. Crap. All right, I'm gonna go run out and look for some sticks real quick. And then, Mob, we're actually gonna have to end the video after this night.
Right.
So, but we will get through this night first. Okay, eat these damn seeds, Tyler. I'm digging up some stick bush thingies, and
All
we'll
right.
plant these next to the base
I got
too.
some grass. Oh, I didn't mean to do
Oh,
that.
cool. Yeah, plant those as well. The tufts of grass are also great for on the fire, but grass is also like it's probably the most commonly used thing because of rope. So we want to generally lean away from wasting tufts on that. But okay, food, crock pot. We're making advancements in this world. We'll put this bad boy down here. And then basically with the crock pot, we can throw in food, and it will make us better food. So I'm gonna put in one monster meat, and then let's go with a leafy meat, which apparently cannot be cooked in the crock pot. Cool. How about okay, birch nuts? Nope, those can't be put in the crock pot. Frog legs. There we go.
No
You got
frog
anything else you
legs.
want?
With
I want to chuck anything in here?
I don't
I got
know.
one slot.
What
So
would you?
just chuck something random.
No, can't put that. No, I have nothing edible I can throw in there, unless
Crap, I
like
just
your
ate
meat.
one of the morsels raw. I just took
Oh.
some food from the thing. I'll put a another frog leg in there, and then we'll let that cook, and in the next episode we'll see what kind of brilliant creation that makes. If you guys enjoyed the start of a new series, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, go check out Moe's channel, it'll be in the description down below.
And go check out Alexa Kid's channel. Same thing,
Yo, that made some
description.
freaking meatballs. Hell yeah, dude.
Link in the description.
We'll see you guys next time.
See ya.
Bye.